Hello friends, this video is a quick view on the NIST special publication 800-145, which is a industry accepted document for the definition of cloud computing. So if you want to know about what exactly cloud computing means, what are the characteristics of cloud computing, what are the service models of a cloud computing, and what are the different deployment models in cloud computing, then this is the document which you should refer. As per this document, the cloud computing is a model for enabling ubiquitous, convenient, on-demand network access to a shared pool of configurable computing resources such as network, servers, storage, application, and app services that can be rapidly provisioned and released with minimum management effort or service provider interaction. So that's what a cloud means. So if anything which is having all these properties, then we call it as a cloud. So as per this document, the five essential characteristics of cloud computing are on-demand self-service, broad network access, resource pooling, rapid elasticity, and measured service. Let's check out the meaning of each one of these one by one. The first characteristic of cloud computing is on-demand self-service. As per this characteristic, the cloud consumer can provision network capabilities such as server, compute, and network storage as needed automatically without requiring any human interaction with the service provider. Means the consumer can provision the resources from the pool using on-demand self-service. They manage their resources by themselves without talking to a human administrator. So the next characteristic is broad network access. As per this characteristic, the resources are available over a network without any need for direct physical access. Also, there should never be any bandwidth bottlenecks. This can be achieved by using technologies such as routing techniques, load balancing, multi-site hosting. The network is not necessarily the part of this service. So the next characteristic of cloud computing is resource pooling. As per this characteristic, the cloud provider abstract the resources and collect them into a pool. So resources can be allocated to the customer from the pool resources based on some policy as per the account of that particular customer. These characteristics make the cloud a financially viable model. Example of resources are storage, processing power, memory, and network bandwidth. So the next characteristic is rapid elasticity. This characteristic allows the consumer to expand or contract the resources they use from the pool. We call this as provisioning and deprovisioning. Often this is completely automatic process. This allows them to more closely match the resource consumption with demand. For example, adding virtual servers, compute, memory, or demand as the demand will increase, and then shutting them down when the demand will drop. The next characteristic is rapid elasticity. This characteristic allows consumer to expand or contract the resources they use from the pool. We call this as provisioning and deprovisioning. Often this is completely automatic process. This allows them to more closely match the resource consumption with demand. For example, adding virtual server, compute, memory as the demand will increase, and then shutting them down back when the demand will drop. And the next service is measured service. Cloud system automatically control and optimize resource use by leveraging a metering capability at some level of abstraction, which is appropriate to that particular type of the service. Example, storage, processing, bandwidth, and active user accounts. So resource uses can be monitored, controlled, and reported, providing transparency for both the provider and the consumer of that particular service. Now let's check out the cloud service model as per the NIST document. The service model means that how exactly the customer will get the service from the cloud model. So there are three different cloud service model as per this NIST document. These are software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service. Let's take these one by one. First one is software as a service, or we call it as a SaaS, S-A-A-S. In this service model, the full application is managed and hosted by the provider only, means cloud service provider. Consumer just access it with a web browser, mobile app, or a lightweight client application. Cloud service provider in case of SaaS is responsible for everything like administration, patching, updating the software as well. The cloud customer is basically only involved in uploading and processing of the data on a full production environment which is hosted by the cloud service provider. So CSP, cloud service provider, is responsible for all the infrastructure, compute, operating system, storage, and the application itself. End user only sees the application. A good example of this is the email which we use on day-to-day basis, like Gmail. So the next service model is PaaS, that is Platform as a Service. In this service model, the CSP provide operating system, development environment or application platform such as database or any other application platform like Python platform, PHP platform or any other code platforms. Or they can provide file storage services and collaboration or even some proprietary application processing facility they can provide. The key differentiator is that with PaaS, you do not manage the underlying servers, network, operating system or other infrastructure. The last one is the infrastructure as a service, that is IaaS. This kind of service model offer access to resource pool of fundamental computing infrastructure such as compute, network or storage. On IaaS, customer can install any software, operating system, because they get a virtual machine which they themselves created on the cloud. CSP, cloud service provider, just manage the facility, like providing physical security to the servers, taking care of the wires, rack and server, etc. And the customer will be responsible for all logical resources such as software, security, logical security, operating system. The CSP simply supply the compute, storage and networking function in this particular model. And in the last, this document provide information on the way the cloud can be deployed in any environment. So as per this document, the cloud can be deployed in four different ways. These are public cloud, private cloud, community cloud or hybrid cloud. Taking them one by one, first one, the public cloud. In this, the cloud infrastructure is made available to the general public or a large industry group and is owned by a organization which sells cloud services. The resources are hardware, software, facility and staff are owned and operated by the service provider, that is a cloud service provider, and then they will sell the services or they will lease or rent the services to further customers. Like AWS, Azure, Google Cloud are the example of this. The next is private cloud. The cloud infrastructure in a private cloud is operated only for a single organization. It may be managed by the organization or by a third party and may be located on the premises or off the premises. The next deployment model is community cloud. In this, the cloud infrastructure is owned and shared by several organizations and they support a specific community that has shared concern. Example, a particular mission, a security requirement, policy or compliance consideration. It may be managed by the organizations or by a third party and may be located on premises or off premises. The last one is the hybrid cloud. The cloud infrastructure is a composition of two or more clouds. Example, private community or public community type of the cloud that remain unique but are bound together by standard or proprietary technologies that enable data and application portability. Example of this is cloud bursting for load balancing. So this is all in the NIST Special Publication 800-145 document. So keeps on watching for more such information videos and create a strong understanding of the standards and guideline document. Thank you, friends.